Welcome to chemistry class. Today I am discussing haloalkanes and haloarenes, part 3. The most common reactions that occur in haloalkanes and haloarenes are nucleophilic substitution reactions and electrophilic substitution reactions. First of all, the nucleophilic substitution reactions. What are nucleophiles? They are nucleus loving, or they may be anions or groups with lone pairs. So if such groups are substituted here in haloalkanes, for example, we are taking RX as the haloalkane. So when it reacts with the nucleophile, what will happen here? This bond will break. This will break. And this X will be replaced from here. And this nucleophile is substituted here. And you will get this product like this. That is, instead of X, here it is the nucleophile. So the nucleophile is substituted here by replacing the halogen from there. So this like reactions are called the nucleophilic substitution reactions. And we can see some examples here. The first example is that is with sodium hydroxide. See here the product. So when it reacts with the sodium hydroxide, the splitting is like this. Split it like Na plus and OH minus. And this OH minus that acts as the nucleophile and that is substituted instead of this halogen. So this halogen is replaced from here and this OH minus is substituted there. So you'll get the answer like this. Along with the alkyl group, the OH is substituted there. So that is an alcohol produced. And what is remained there? That is sodium and X that joined together forming NaX as the byproduct. And the second reaction, that is the reaction with water. The water can be splitted like this as H plus and OH minus. And you can have the nucleophile here, that is again OH minus. So that is the negatively charged group here, that is the anion. So that acts as the nucleophile here. So again the product, that is along with the alkyl group, the OH is substituted there. So what is the byproduct? That is H and X, which join together forming HX. Then the third reactant, that is, it reacts with the sodium iodide. And here the splitting is like this as Na plus and I minus. So which is the nucleophile here? Yes, that is I minus. So that is substituted here and you will get the product like this. R along with iodine, that is a new group, that is the nucleophile that is substituted there. So what is remained there? That is sodium and X that joined together forming NaX. And the next reactant, that is sodium alkoxide. What is an alcohol? The alcohol is ROH, isn't it? If you are replacing one hydrogen from there by using the sodium, replacing the hydrogen with a sodium, it will become RONA. So which is called sodium alkoxide. What is the name of the reagent? This is sodium alkoxide, isn't it? Then how the splitting? So during the addition, during the substitution, the splitting is like this as Na plus and RO minus. So which is a nucleophile here? That is a negatively charged group, isn't it? So that is RO minus. And where the splitting, that is between oxygen and sodium. So the valency is free along with oxygen. So oxygen de oru bond aanu nammalode break cheyidirikkunnu. So oxygen should be attached here. So we'll get the product like this. The R, that is from the alkyl group. And from here this OR group. So you can attach that as OR group. So what is the product obtained here? That is ROR. What is the name of the product? That is an ether, isn't it? ROR is an oxygen and the functional group. So this is an ether. And what is the byproduct? Again, that is the sodium that is remain here. And the X, that as NaX. So instead of the sodium hydroxide, you can use potassium hydroxide also. So you have to take aqueous sodium hydroxide or aqueous potassium hydroxide. So you can use two reagents here, aqueous sodium hydroxide or aqueous potassium hydroxide. If it is KOH, you will get the byproduct as KX here. That is potassium and X from here. So these are the some of the reactions, and we can have some more reactions. First of all, what is the product obtained when it react with ammonia? So ammonia can be splitted as NH2 and H. The ammonia can be splitted as NH2 and H. So which is the positively charged group? That is H plus, isn't it? So which is negatively charged? That is NH2 minus. So which is the nucleophile here? That is NH2. So what is the product obtained? Yes, that is R along with the NH2 group. That is an amine, isn't it? So what is the name of this particular class? These are primary amines. And what to put the byproduct? That is the remaining, that is H and X. Again, HX. So this is with ammonia, and if you are using primary amine, so this is the primary amine, that is RNH2. So when it react with the primary amine, it's splitted like this as RNH and H. The splitting is like this, RNH and H. So which is the positively charged group? That is H plus. What about RNH? That become minus. So which is substituted here? This is the nucleophile. So that is substituted here as R. So which is the one with the free valency? Ivideyana break cheyidirikkunathu NH inde ivideyana break cheyidirikkunathu. So nitrogen odu kudiyana oru free valency varunathu. So nammal idu kodukkunna samayathu thirichu nammal idu join cheyipikkanam. Ivideyano valency free aayittullathu, ivideyano break cheyathathu, avideyana nammal attach cheyyanathu. So we will get the product like this. This is as NHR. So this is the nucleophile plus the remaining H and X. So HX. So here this is NHR. That indicates this is a secondary amine here. So when ammonia react with the haloalkane, you will get primary amine. So when primary amine react with the haloalkane, you will get secondary amine. If it is secondary amine, you will get tertiary amine, like that. And the next reagent, that is potassium cyanide here. So how the splitting? Can you predict the splitting here? Yes, it is like this. K and CON minus. So this act as the negatively charged group and this as positively charged group. So which is the nucleophile here? That is cyanide. So here the product obtained is R CN. So here the cyanide group is attached. And if it is with silver cyanide, AgCN, you will get a product which is different from this, and the product is like this, that is RNC. So here this CN group have two modes of attachment. The one is through carbon and the other is through nitrogen. Such groups are called ambidend nucleophiles, or they are ambidend groups. And why the difference? Here this potassium cyanide is an ionic compound. This is an ionic compound, but this is covalent. So if it is ionic, this potassium cyanide, that is completely ionized in solution as K plus and CN minus. So both this carbon end and nitrogen end are free to attach with this alkyl group. So both the ends, that means the carbon end and the nitrogen end, are free to attach with the carbon of the alkyl group. But the carbon-carbon bond is more stronger. Carbon-carbon bond is more stronger than carbon-nitrogen bond. So this will form. Carbon-carbon bond formation is there. And you will get alkyl cyanides. Or they are called, the IUPAC name is nitriles. So what are these compounds? These are cyanides or nitriles, isn't it? So what about silver cyanide? This is covalent in nature, and do not ionize in a form or do not ionize in its solutions. And what about the CN group? Only the nitrogen end is free here. In case of AgCN, only the nitrogen end is free. This end is free. Okay. So only the formation is with the nitrogen. That means the bond formation is through the nitrogen instead of carbon. So here the product is RNC. So what are the name? That is isocyanates. They are isocyanates, or they are called isonitriles. So feel the difference? Here potassium cyanide is ionic. Both ends, that means carbon end and nitrogen end, are free, so it can form bonds with the alkyl group through carbon or through nitrogen. But the carbon-carbon bond, this is more stronger. This is more stronger than carbon-nitrogen bond. So first, it forms the cyanide. So here, the chances for the formation of cyanide. But in case of silver cyanide, because it is covalent, only the nitrogen end is free, so it form bonds through nitrogen. So you'll get isocyanate instead of cyanides. And here another group, that also ambident nucleophile. Here the group, that is potassium nitrate. If you are treating that with potassium nitrate, here this NO2 group. This group have two modes of attachment. It can form bond either through nitrogen or through oxygen. And here first with the KNO2, it forms the bonding, the product through the nitrogen and through the oxygen. Here the bond is like this. Here the grouping is like this, RONO. And with AgNO2, it forms RNO2. See here the difference. The first nitrides. These compounds are called nitrides. And with the silver nitrate, it forms nitroalkynes. So these are nitro compounds and these are nitrides. So again an ambident group. So two ambident groups are here, that is cyanide and NO2 group. So what are ambident nucleophiles? The groups which have two modes of attachment is called an ambident nucleophile. The first example, that is cyanide. It can form two different compounds. One is cyanide and the other one is isocyanide through carbon and nitrogen. And the second example, that is NO2. It can form two different compounds. If it is through N, then it is NO2, that is nitro compounds. If it is through oxygen, the compounds are called nitrides. Okay, clear? See some more examples here. You can discuss with silver salt of carboxylic acid. What is the product obtained there? And what is carboxylic acid? You can write the equation. You can write the formula as RCOH, isn't it? If you are replacing the hydrogen with a silver like this, RCOOAG, this is silver salt of carboxylic acid. What is this? This is silver salt of carboxylic acid. So how the splitting? So this is a positively charged group, that is silver. So that become AG plus. And what about this group? That become RCOO minus, carboxylate group. So here this will attach to the alkyl group by replacing the halogen from there, and you will get the product like this. R group, that is from here, and the new group, that is OCOR. The here the splitting, the valence is free along with this oxygen. That is why here this oxygen is attached. And what about this? You can write this as this OR RCO in a reverse form, RCOOR. And this is actually ester. ഈ കിട്ടിയിരിക്കുന്നത് എസ്റ്റർ ആണ്, ആർ സി. നമുക്കിത് തിരിച്ചെഴുതിയിരിക്കുന്നതാണ്, ഞാൻ ആർ ഒ സി ഒ ആർ എന്നുള്ളത് നേരെ തിരിച്ചു കൊടുത്ത ആർ സി ഒ ഒ ആർ, ദെൻ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി എസ്റ്റർ. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദ പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് ഒബ്റ്റെയിൻഡ് ഈസ് എസ്റ്റർ ഹിയർ. സോ വാട്ട് ഇസ് റിമൈൻഡർ? ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് സിൽവർ അലോങ് വിത്ത് ദിസ് എക്സ്, ദാറ്റ് ഫോംസ് എച്ച് ജി എക്സ്, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ ബൈ പ്രോഡക്റ്റ്. And the last reaction that is along with lithium aluminium hydride, which is a best reducing agent. Lithium aluminium hydride, which acts as a reducing agent and which can provide hydrogen to this compound. So this halogen is substituted by hydrogen and you will get the product like this. R instead of halogen, here it is hydrogen. So if it is CH3 here, so these are different reactions, different nucleophilic substitution reactions. In all these cases, the halogen is replaced by a nucleophile. But nalla halogen maatittu nammal oru nucleophile ne ivide substitute cheyyuvaanu. Appo edukkana nucleophiles nalla nammal ivide kandu kaniyum. Appo nammal ivide idinu pagaram, suppose instead of this R, if you are giving CH3 here, and instead of X we are taking chlorine. The reactions are like this. Here the product will be like this. That means this R group is replaced by CH3 here. So you will get methylamine as the product. So if it is replaced here, that means here, when this methyl chloride react with the lithium aluminium here, hydride, what will be the product there? You will get the product as CH3H. What is the CH3H? That is equivalent to CH4, isn't it? So that is a hydrocarbon. So when it react with the lithium aluminium hydride, the reduction will occur and haloalkanes are changed to corresponding hydrocarbons. Here, if it is with two carbon member, you will get a two carbon member of the alkane. Okay, so that's about the nucleophilic substitution reactions. And now we have the mechanism of the nucleophilic substitution reactions. We have two mechanisms for the nucleophilic substitution reactions, that is SN1 and SN2. And what is this SN1 and SN2 stands for? That is substitution nucleophilic unimolecular and substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. So first of all, we are taking the SN2 mechanism. That is, what is this S stands for? That is substitution here. Substitution nucleophilic, that is SN, bimolecular. Bi means two. Molecularity is two here. So now take as an example here. That is the first example, that is CH3Cl. When it react with a nucleophile, for example here aqueous sodium hydroxide, so from that you will get OH minus as the nucleophile. So what is the product obtained here? That is CH3, and the Cl is replaced by OH here, that is the incoming nucleophile, plus the chloride ion that is replaced from there. So when we are considering this reaction, we can write the Wurtgen dash formula for this reaction. That is, as the carbon here, the first hydrogen that is pointing towards you, the second hydrogen that is pointing away from you, and the third hydrogen, and here the chlorine, that is the leaving group. That should be replaced. This should be replaced from here. So this is the compound. So when this OH minus approaches this molecule, this carbon is actually a sp3 hybridized carbon, and this is this hydrogen is pointing to towards you, this hydrogen, and this is pointing away from you, and this is this hydrogen and this chlorine lying in the plane of the bond, isn't it? So if the OH is approach this molecule, this is a primary halide, isn't it? This is a primary halide, isn't it? And for to take this reaction properly, the OH should be approached from the side which is opposite to that of this leaving group. That means the OH should be approached from this side, that is from this side, to attack this molecule. ഇവിടുന്ന് OH ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് സൈഡിൽ നിന്നാണ് ഈ OH- ഇവിടെ അപ്രോച്ച് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. സോ വാട്ട് വിൽ ഹാപ്പൻ? ദ This OH make a weak bond between between the oxygen and the carbon, and this carbon chlorine bond become weak, and we can show the bond formation like this. That means the OH that is approached from the left side, that forms a weak bond to carbon, and here this bond that is already present there, and this hydrogen is also there, and the hydrogen that is bonded through wedge that also there, and what about this carbon chlorine? That bond become weak, and in the next stage this will break, and this is left from the molecule as Cl minus. So you'll get Cl minus as the product. That is one product. What about the other product? So because of the approach of this OH minus, these three hydrogens, this hydrogens that pushed in an opposite way, opposite direction. So OH minus approach in the samayathu adu ee varuna bonds ne repel cheyum in an opposite direction, because that is from the side which is opposite to that of this chloride. So chlorine de opposite nana ee OH approach cheyna adond idu endeyum idu opposite direction like idine repel cheyum. So we'll get a structure like this. See, here OH is in the left side, and this hydrogen is there itself, and here the hydrogen that is represented by wedge, this is one hydrogen, the second hydrogen here, the third one here, and here the OH. So what about this configurations of the first and last molecule? Here chlorine is in the right side and these hydrogens are pointing towards left. Here this is pointing towards right in an opposite direction. So what about the configuration? During SN2 mechanism there is inversion occurs. Inversion of configuration. During SN2 mechanism there is an inversion of configuration. നേരത്തെ എന്തായിരുന്നു ഉണ്ടായിരുന്ന കോൺഫിഗറേഷൻ അതിന്റെ ജസ്റ്റ് ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് ആണ് ഇപ്പൊ കിട്ടിയിരിക്കുന്ന കോൺഫിഗറേഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഹിയർ വി ഹാവ് ടു റിമെമ്പർ സം ഓർ പോയിന്റ്സ് ഇൻ ഓർഡർ ടു ടേക്സ് പ്ലേസ് ദിസ് റിയാക്ഷൻ പ്രോപ്പർലി. ദ ന്യൂക്ലിയോഫൈൽ ഷുഡ് അപ്രോച്ച് ദ മോളിക്യുൾ ഫ്രം ദ സൈഡ് വിച്ച് ഇസ് ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് ടു ദാറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ലിവിംഗ് ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഓർ ദ ഹാലൈഡ്. ഏതാണ് ഇവിടുത്തെ ഹാലജൻ, അതിന്റെ ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് സൈഡിൽ നിന്ന് മാത്രമേ ഇതിനെ അപ്രോച്ച് ചെയ്താലേ പ്രോപ്പർ ആയിട്ട് റിയാക്ഷൻ നടക്കുള്ളൂ. And the second thing is, here both the bond breaking and the bond making that takes place at the same time. So this is a single stage process. ee process nu parayna oru single stage process aanu. And what about the rate of the reaction? You can write the rate law here. Rate is equivalent to K into, that depends upon the concentration of both that is the halide and the nucleophile. So you can write the rate law as rate is equivalent to K into concentration of CH3Cl, that is chloromethane, into concentration of the nucleophile, that is OH minus. So here the power is equivalent to 1. Here it is 1, here it is 1. So what about the order of the reaction? Order is equivalent to X plus Y, that is the powers of the concentration terms. ഇവിടുത്തെ കോൺസെൻട്രേഷൻ ടേംസിന്റെ പവർ ഹാലോൽക്കൈനിന്റെ പവർ 1 ആണ്, ന്യൂക്ലിയോഫൈലിന്റെ പവറും 1 ആണ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇക്വലന്റ് ടു 1 പ്ലസ് 1, സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇക്വലന്റ് ടു 2. സോ വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദ മോളിക്കുലാരിറ്റി ഹിയർ? ഈ റിയാക്ഷൻ നടക്കണമെങ്കിൽ മിനിമം രണ്ട് മോളിക്യൂൾസ് വേണം. ഏത് മോളിക്യൂൾസ് ഒക്കെയാണ് വേണ്ടത്? ഹാലോൽക്കൈൻ വേണം, അതുപോലെ ന്യൂക്ലിയോഫൈൽ വേണം. രണ്ടും കൂടെ ഒരേ സമയത്ത് കൊളൈഡ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോഴാണ് റിയാക്ഷൻ നടക്കുന്നത്. സോ വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദ മോളിക്കുലാരിറ്റി? ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് മോളിക്യൂൾസ് ദാറ്റ് കൊളൈഡ് സൈമൾട്ടേനിയസ്ലി ടു ബ്രിങ് അബൌട്ട് ദ കെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻ. That also equivalent to 2. So it is a single stage process. Both bond breaking and bond making takes place at the same time. Order equal to 2, molecularity equal to 2. And what about the configuration? There is inversion of configuration takes place. Okay. And what about the order of reactivity? This is a primary alkyl halide. The order of reactivity is the primary that is highest than secondary, which is greater than that of tertiary haloalkanes. So the highest reactivity is for the primary alkyl halide. And now the SN1 mechanism, And this S stands for substitution and N for nucleophilic. And what is this one stands for? That is unimolecular. What is meant by uni? That is one. That means molecularity is one here. So you can take as an example here, that is a tertiary halide. You can take the tertiary halide as CH3 thrice CBr. It's a bromide. It's a tertiary bromide. So when it reacts with the nucleophile, can you predict a product? Yes, this is CH3 thrice C. Here instead of bromine, the OH is substituted by replacing the bromine here like this as bromide. So this reaction a substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction that actually involved two stages. The stage one, that is the formation of the carbocation. The stage one means that is formation of carbocation from the tertiary carbon. So you can write the equation like this. Here are the first carbon that joined with CH3, the second CH3 here, the third CH3, and along with this bromine. So this is a slow stage, and here the breaking takes place. Here the breaking between carbon and bromine, and this is a slow stage, and you will get the product like this. The carbon halogen bond is removed from the halogen is removed from here, and you will get breaking is like this. The electron is shifted towards bromine, and this become positive. So this become a positively charged carbon, and for this carbon, this is actually sp3 hybridized carbon. This is sp3 hybridized carbon and is tetrahedral. And what about this carbon? This become sp2 hybridized due to this formation, due to this breaking, and we can show this as triangular planar here. See the bonding here. Here one CH3. Can show the bonding like this. Here one CH3. Here the bond that is pointing towards you, and here the CH3 that is lying in the same plane of the bond. Okay. അപ്പോൾ ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ ഇത് കാർബോക്കേറ്റേൺ ആയിട്ട് ഫോം ചെയ്യുന്ന സമയത്ത് ദിസ് ബിക്കം sp2 ഹൈബ്രിഡൈസ്ഡ് കാർബൺ. സോ ഇഫ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് sp2 ഹൈബ്രിഡൈസ്ഡ് കാർബൺ, ഹിയർ ദ ബോണ്ട് ഈസ് ലൈങ് ഇൻ ദ സെയിം പ്ലെയിൻ, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദിസ് ബിക്കം ട്രയാംഗുലർ പ്ലാനാർ. ഇറ്റ് ദിസ് മോളിക്യൂൾ ബിക്കം ട്രയാംഗുലർ പ്ലാനാർ ഡ്യൂ ടു ദ sp2 ഹൈബ്രിഡൈസ്ഡ് നേച്ചർ. And when it become sp2 hybridized, because the planar planarity, the OH should be approached from the molecule from all sides equally. Means OH ne namukku ഏത് സൈഡിൽ നിന്ന് വേണമെങ്കിലും ഇതിനെ അപ്രോച്ച് ചെയ്യാം, കാരണം ഇതെല്ലാം ഒരേ പ്ലെയിനിലാണ് കിടക്കുന്നത്. സോ നമുക്ക് രണ്ട് സൈഡിൽ നിന്ന് ഇതിനെ അപ്രോച്ച് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും, ഫ്രം ഹിയർ, ദ ഫ്രം ദിസ് സൈഡ് ഓർ ഫ്രം ദ ബാക്ക് സൈഡ്. That means from the side which is opposite to that of this bromine, or from the side which is same as that of this bromine. So that is the second stage, that is stage 2. That is the attack of nucleophile. What is stage 2? That is attack of nucleophile on carbocation. സെക്കൻഡ് സ്റ്റേജിൽ നമ്മൾ റിയാക്ഷൻ നോക്കുക. ഹിയർ ദ ന്യൂക്ലിയോഫൈൽ, ഹിയർ ദ കാർബോക്കേറ്റിയോൺ. ഹിയർ വി കൻ ഡ്രോ ദ കാർബോക്കേറ്റിയോൺ, ദറ്റ് ഇസ് CCH3. ദ സെക്കൻഡ് CH3, ദ തേർഡ് CH3 വിത്ത് എ പോസിറ്റീവ് ചാർജ് ഹിയർ. And when it reacts with the nucleophile, that is the second stage, attack of the nucleophile on this molecule. So there is equal possibilities the OH can approach from this side or the OH can approach from this side. Equal possibilities are there. OH can approach from both the sides. And there is equal chances for the formation of the bonds. And in the first case, the OH can maintain. The OH can maintain its own position. That means the molecule can maintain its own configuration without changing the configuration. Here the CH3, here the second CH3, and here the third CH3. മൂന്ന് സേസ് ത്രീസും പഴയ പൊസിഷൻസ് തന്നെ മെയിൻറ്റെയിൻ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. ആൻഡ് OH ഇസ് ഇൻ ദ സെയിം പൊസിഷൻ ആസ് ദാറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ബ്രോമിൻ. എവിടെയാണോ ബ്രോമിൻ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നത് അവിടെ തന്നെയാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ OH വന്നിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഓർ പ്ലസ് ദർ ഇസ് അനദർ ചാൻസ് ഇൻ വിച്ച് ഇൻവേർഷൻ ടേക്സ് പ്ലേസ്. ദറ്റ് മീൻസ് CH3 ടുവേർഡ്സ് ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഇൻ ആൻ ഇൻവേർട്ടഡ് പൊസിഷൻ ഹ്യർ. ദ ഹ്യർ ദ സെക്കൻഡ് CH3 ആൻഡ് ഹ്യർ ദ തേർഡ് CH3. And you will get the product like this. The OH is in the opposite direction. So there is equal possibilities for inversion and retention here. So this is this maintains the same configuration as that of the reactant molecule. So here there is retention of configuration. Here there is retention of configuration. So what about here? There is inversion occurs. So here there is inversion of configuration, isn't it? So there is 50% chance for retention and 50% chance for inversion. And if there is equal chances or equal amounts of inverted and retained forms, then it is called a racemic mixture. This is called a racemic mixture. That means equal amounts of inverted form and there is equal number of molecules with retention of configuration. Okay, the mixture is called a racemic mixture and this is called phenomenon is called racemization. Okay, and what about the rate of the reaction here? The rate depends only on the slow step. Which is the slow step here? This is the slow step. Stage 1 is the slow step and this is called rate determining step. And which molecule is take part in chemical reaction? That is only the tertiary alkyl halide, not the nucleophile. So the rate depends only on the concentration of the halide, which is the halide that is CH3 thrice CBr, isn't it? So what about the order of the reaction? Order is equivalent to, that means this do not depends upon the concentration of the nucleophile. ഇവിടെ കോൺസെൻട്രേഷൻ ഓഫ് ദി ന്യൂക്ലിയോഫൈൽ റേറ്റിനെ ഡിപ്പെൻഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. അങ്ങനെ ആയതുകൊണ്ട് ഇവിടുത്തെ പവർ എത്രയാണ്? ഓൺലി ദ ഹാലൈഡ് ഡിപ്പെൻഡ്സ്. ദറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഓർഡർ ഓഫ് ദി റിയാക്ഷൻ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 1. സൊ ഹൗ മെനി മോളിക്യൂൾസ് ടേക്ക് പാർട്ട് ഇൻ ദ കെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻ? ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഓൺലി 1. സൊ മോളിക്യുലാരിറ്റി ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 1 അഗെയിൻ. സൊ മോളിക്യുലാരിറ്റി ഈക്വൽ ടു 1 ഹിയർ. സോ വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദി കോൺഫിഗറേഷൻസ്? There is equal chance for the retention of configuration and inversion of configuration. What about the order of reactivity here? That is the highest. This is an example for tertiary. Nammal ivide discuss cheyda tertiary halide aanu. This is a tertiary halide. The reactivity is maximum for the tertiary halide for SN1 and tertiary greater than secondary, which is greater than primary. That is the order. Okay, so compare the reactions here. SN1 and SN2 mechanisms. Here, what is meant by SN1? That is substitution. This S stands for substitution. Nucleophilic, unimolecular. Unimolecular means one. Molecularity is equivalent to 1. So here, order equal to 1. Molecularity equal to 1. So what about the mechanism? That is a two-stage process. The first stage is the formation of the carbocation. And the second is the attack of nucleophile. And what about the configurational change? There is inversion of configuration and retention of configuration. And what about the order of reactivity? Tertiary greater than secondary, which is greater than primary. What about SN2 here? That is substitution. Nucleophilic bimolecular. What is meant by bi? That is 2. What about order of the reaction? That is 2. What about molecularity? That is 2. It's a single stage process, and breaking and making of the bond takes place at the same time. What about the configurational change? Always an inversion of configuration occurs. What about the order of reactivity? That is primary greater than secondary, which is greater than tertiary. So remember the term SN1 is not primary. ഇതങ്ങോട്ടും മാറിപ്പോലെ ചാൻസ് കൂടുതലാണ്. സോ SN1 എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് എന്താണ്? ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് പ്രൈമറി എന്ന് ഓർത്തിരിക്കാം. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ടേഴ്സറി. സോ സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ഫ്രം ടേഴ്സറി ഗ്രേറ്റ് ദാൻ സെക്കൻഡറി ഗ്രേറ്റ് ദാൻ പ്രൈമറി. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ ഓർഡർ ഓഫ് റിയാക്ടിവിറ്റി. ദെൻ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ SN2 ഇസ് റിവേഴ്സ് ഓർഡർ. സോ റിമെമ്പർ വൺസ് മോർ, SN1 ഇസ് നോട്ട് പ്രൈമറി. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് SN1 ഇസ് ടേഴ്സറി. ഓക്കെ. സോ വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് SN2? ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ റിവേഴ്സ് ഓർഡർ. So that is about the nucleophilic substitution reactions here. Now the electrophilic substitution reactions. What is meant by an electrophile? Electrophile is electron loving, or they may be cations or electron deficient groups, isn't it? So we can have the reactions mainly in halogens, because this benzene ring that is highly electron rich, for that we can take the chlorobenzene as the first example. So here there is chlorobenzene. So when it react with an electrophile, this will be substituted here in the ring. And the position of the electrophile in the ring, that is decided by the chlorine that is already present in the ring, and that is based on resonance, isn't it? Here this is the resonating structures for chlorobenzene. Here there is 6 electrons. One of the electron is shifted from here to here. At the same time, there is shifting from here to here, making this position more electron rich. And due to the shifting again, double shifting is there from here to here. That will make a shifting from here to here. This bond will break. And the negative charge is shifted to here. And in the next shifting, the electron is shifted from here to here, and the breaking will take place here, and the final shifting is to here. That means here this is this position, that is 1-2 position, this is 1-4 position, and this is 1-2 position. So where is the negative charge is concentrated? So from the 5 structures that is given by resonance effect, ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ ഇലക്ട്രോൺസ് കോൺസെൻട്രേറ്റ് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്ന എവിടെയാണ്? ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഓർത്തോ പൊസിഷൻസ് ഓർ അറ്റ് പാരാ പൊസിഷൻസ്. ഓർത്തോ പൊസിഷൻസ് ഓർ പാരാ പൊസിഷൻസ്. സോ ദിസ് ക്ലോറോബെൻസീൻ ഇസ് ഓർത്തോ പാരാ ഡയറക്ടിംഗ്. ദിസ് ഇസ് ഓർത്തോ പാരാ ഡയറക്ടിംഗ് ഗ്രൂപ്പ്. അറ്റ് ദ സെയിം ടൈം ദർ ഇസ് ഐ ഇഫക്റ്റ് ഓൾസോ. ദറ്റ് മീൻസ് ദ ക്ലോറിൻ ഹാസ് ദ ടെൻഡൻസി ടു വിത്ത്ഡ്രോ ദ ഇലക്ട്രോൺസ് ഫ്രം ഹിയർ, ഫ്രം ദ റിംഗ് ടുവേർഡ്സ് ഇറ്റ്. റിംഗിൽ നിന്ന് ഇലക്ട്രോൺസിനെ ഇങ്ങോട്ട് വലിക്കാനുള്ള ടെൻഡൻസി ഉണ്ട്. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഐ ഇഫക്റ്റ്. ദിസ് എഫക്ട് ഇസ് റെസൊണൻസ് എഫക്ട്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് അൻ ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് എഫക്ട്. സോ ദാറ്റ് മേക്ക് ദ റിംഗ് മോർ ഡീആക്ടിവേറ്റഡ്. സോ ദ ഇലക്ട്രോഫൈൽസ് ക്യാൻ ബി സബ്സ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ടഡ് ഓൺലി ഇൻ ദ റിംഗ് അണ്ടർ ഡ്രാസ്റ്റിക് കണ്ടീഷൻസ്. നോർമൽ കണ്ടീഷൻസിൽ ഇലക്ട്രോഫിലിക് സബ്സ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസ് കുറച്ച് ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടാണ്. എന്നിരുന്നാലും ഡ്രാസ്റ്റിക് കണ്ടീഷൻസിൽ ഇലക്ട്രോഫിലിക് സബ്സ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻ റിയാക്ഷൻസ് നടക്കുന്നുണ്ട് ക്ലോറോബെൻസീൻ വെൻ കമ്പയർഡ് വിത്ത് ബെൻസീൻ. So endokiyana reactions nalla namukivada nokkam. So what will happen here? So when this electrophile is substituted here, this chlorine decides the position of this electrophile. That means this chlorine is ortho para directing, direct this substituent either towards this ortho position or towards this para position. So we'll get a mixture of products here. That is the chlorine that is already present here, and a new group that is substituted here at ortho position or at para position. The chlorine is substituted here. The chlorine decides the position of the electrophile. The electrophile may be substituted here at para position, here at ortho position, or at para position. So we'll get a mixture of products, and always the major product is the para product. Okay, so that is the major product. Then we can have some examples now. The first electrophilic substitution reaction, that is halogenation. See, here we can carry out the halogenation first. That is the first reaction. For that, you can add halogen, that is chlorine or bromine, in presence of anhydrous ferric chloride. So here this chlorine undergo breaking. That means the chlorine is breaking is like this. The two chlorines electrons are shifted like this, and one of the chlorine become positive. This become Cl plus. So that is substituted here, either in ortho position or in para position. So that is electrophilic substitution reaction. So how will you draw the structures? The first, the ortho substituent, here already there is chlorine, and the incoming chlorine, that is at ortho position, and the second product, here the benzene, the chlorine is here, and the chlorine at the para position. How will you name this compound? Give the numbers like this. This is 1, this is 2, and this is 1, and this is 4. So how will you give the names? The first one is 1,2-dichlorobenzene. This is 1,2-dichlorobenzene. What about the second one? That is 1,4-dichlorobenzene, isn't it? So here the halogen is substituted, or the chlorine is substituted here. What about this chlorine? That make a complex with FeCl3 that forms FeCl4-. That is a complex here. And the second reaction, which is the nitration. That is the second electrophilic substitution reaction. That is nitration here. And the nitrating mixture, that is concentrated H2SO4 and concentrated HNO3. So a mixture of reactants are there, concentrated H2SO4 and concentrated HNO3. And the HNO3 can be splitted like this as OH and NO2 here. So OH become minus and NO2 become plus. So which is the electrophile? That is this NO2 group. So this is substituted here. So NO2 is the electrophile that is substituted in the ring. And you will get the structure like this. Again, a mixture of product is obtained there. The chlorine that is already present there. And here the NO2 group at ortho position. Plus the chlorobenzene with NO2 group at the para position. So how will you give the names? Here there is two substituents, chlorine and nitro group. So which will come first? That is chlorine alphabetically first. So there is 1, this is 2, and this is 1, this is 4. So how will you name this compound? Yes, this is 1-chloro. This is 1-chloro, 2-nitro. You put a hyphen also there without gap. 1-chloro, 2-nitrobenzene. Isn't it? This is 1-chloro, 2-nitrobenzene. Now the third reaction, that is sulfonation. Here the sulfonation. The reagent used is sulfuric acid, that is concentrated H2SO4. And this is splitted as OH and SO3 H group. OH and SO3 H group. The splitting is like this. This as OH minus, and what about SO3 H group? That is sulfonic group. That is the plus group that act as the electrophile. So this is substituted here. So which group is substituted in the ring? That is this SO3 H group that is substituted here. And what will be the product obtained there? You can write the products like this. The two chlorobenzenes as such, and the two SO3H groups, the one is substituted at ortho position and the other is substituted at para position. So this SO3H that have high priority and taken as the main functional group in the ring. So you have to give the number like this. This S1 and the chlorine S2 and this S1 and the chlorine S4 like this. So how will you name this? If there is no chlorine, this is benzene sulfonic acid. If there is no chlorine, what is the name? This is benzene sulfonic acid. If there is no chlorine. If the chlorine is at the second position, so you have to prefix that before the word root. So benzene sulfonic acid munba adu kodukanam. So that has 2-chloro. So this is 2-chlorobenzene sulfonic acid. What is the main group? That is benzene sulfonic acid. That is the main group. So before that, the substituent, that is 2-chlorobenzene sulfonic acid. So what is the name of this one? This is 4-chlorobenzene sulfonic acid. So here three reactions. The one is halogenation, where the halogen is substituted at ortho and para positions. And the second one is nitration, where the nitrating mixture is used, that is concentrated H2SO4 and HNO3, where NO2 is substituted at ortho and para positions. And the third substituent, that is concentrated sulfuric acid, that is for sulfonation. Again, sulfonic group is substituted. All these cases, the major product is, that is the para product. So always para product is the major product. And we have two more reactions. That is Friedel-Crafts reaction, that is alkylation and acylation. And for alkylation, we are adding the group, that is alkyl group in the ring. So this is the electrophile here. And for acylation, the group is RCO group, RCO plus group. For that, for the first case, we are taking the haloalkane itself. So here, this is haloarene. And we are taking another haloalkane, that is RX generally. With a catalyst here, that is by using anhydrous aluminium chloride, that is common for this. And this also, here also the same catalyst is used. And here the splitting like this means in presence of the anhydrous aluminium chloride, this is splitted as R plus and X minus. So this act as the electrophile, and that is substituted here, and you will get this products like this. So this is chlorobenzene already present, and which is a new group that is substituted here at the ortho position, one alkyl group, and at the para position there is one alkyl group, isn't it? So if you are taking acylation, so we have to use this acyl group. For that acyl group, what is an acyl group? What is an acid group? This is acid, isn't it? RCOH is carboxylic acid. And if you are replacing the OH from this by chlorine, you will get RCOCl. So that is derived from the acid and which is called acid chloride. What is this? This is acid chloride. Or if you are replacing the OH with the corresponding NH2 group, that become RCO NH2. That is an amide. This is an amide. So these groups are derived from acids, so they are called derivatives. So you can use any derivative. There is esters, there is anhydrides, acid chlorides or amides. You can use any of the acid derivative here for the acylation. So here we are taking a simple example, a simple compound, that is acid chloride. That is, we are taking RCOCl. What is the name of this one? This is acid chloride, isn't it? This is acid chloride in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, that is a common catalyst, isn't it? So what is the splitting here? So the splitting is like this, and this become RCOCl minus, and this become RCO plus, and here this is the electrophile. So that is substituted here. So this is the electrophile. So what is the product obtained there? You can write the products like this. The first product that is obtained by replacing the hydrogen with an acyl group here. So here the splitting, that is between carbon and chlorine. So you have to substitute this as COR. So here the valency free plus the para product. It is chlorine is substituted here, and what about the COR group, that is at the para position. So two possibilities are there. One is ortho product and the other one is para product here. So the CO group, that is the CO group is a ketonic group. So this is an aromatic ketone. This compound is an aromatic ketone. So instead of this R group, we can substitute CH3 here. So instead of R group, we can give the CH3 there. So it becomes CH3, and instead of X, you can give Cl here, CH3Cl. So here also you can give CH3COCl. The product obtained is like this. That means this R group is substituted. The R group is replaced like this. This becomes CH3 here. Here CH3, so you can substitute the methyl group. Here this is CH3CO group, and here this is CH3CO group. And the CH3 group, that is called methyl group, isn't it? And you can number this as 1 and 2. What is the name of the compound? This is 1-chloro-2-methylbenzene, isn't it? This is 1-chloro-2-methylbenzene. So an alkyl substituted benzene is obtained there. 1-chloro-2-methylbenzene, and the second one is 1-chloro-4-methylbenzene, isn't it? So how will you name this compound? Yes, this is aceto group, and it's a ketone, and this is phenyl group. This is phenyl group. And where is the position? How will you number this? Here the ketonic group, which have high priority, so this has 1 and this has 2. And what about here? This has 1 and this chlorine has 4. So how do you name this? This is phenyl group, and it's a ketone. So this is phenone, and this is aceto group. That should be prefixed. So what about the name? If there is no chlorine, then the chlorine illengil idinte pere acetophenone ennaanu. If there is no chlorine, this compound is called acetophenone. This ON stands for the ketone, isn't it? Acetophenone. And at the second position, there is chlorine. So what is the name? That should be prefixed. That is 2-chloroacetophenone. What is the name? This is 2-chloroacetophenone. And what about here? This is fourth position and chlorine. So what is the name? That is 4-chloroacetophenone. That is the name. Okay. So, we will do the electrophilic substitution reactions. Here, electrophiles are substituted. So, what is Friedel-Crafts alkylation? That is when haloarenes react with the alkyl halides or haloalkanes in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride. The alkyl groups are substituted at ortho and para positions, or an ortho plus para products are formed there. The reaction is called alkylation. So, if acyl group is substituted, the reaction is called Friedel-Crafts acylation. Remember the catalyst? The catalyst is always anhydrous aluminium chloride. And the last topic in this lesson, that is polyhalogen compound. So, what is meant by polyhalogen compound? Poly means that is many. What is poly? Poly means many. Means containing more than one halogens. For example, if there is methane, if you are replacing one hydrogen from that, by using a halogen, it becomes CH3Cl. If you are replacing two hydrogens, you will get that as CH2Cl2. If it is by three hydrogens, it becomes CHCl3. If it is by 4 hydrogens, it becomes CCl4. And what is this compound? This is trichloromethane, isn't it? It's a polyhalogen compound. This is trichloromethane. And there is a special name for this compound. This is commonly known as chloroform. This is commonly known as chloroform. And there are mainly three uses for the chloroform. The one is it is used as a solvent. And secondly, it is used as an anesthetic. It is used as an anesthetic. And thirdly, it is used for the preparation of the refrigerants. It's used for the preparation of refrigerants. Especially Freon. R22 എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഫ്രയോണിൻ്റെ പ്രിപ്പറേഷന് വേണ്ടിയിട്ടും ഇത് ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നു, ക്ലോറോഫോം ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നു. ബട്ട് ആക്ച്വലി ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വൺസ് യൂസ്ഡ് ആസ് അനസ്തെറ്റിക് ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് നൗ റീപ്ലേസ്ഡ് ഡ്യൂ ടു ഇറ്റ്സ് പോയ്സണസ് നേച്ചർ. ഇഫ് ദർ ഇസ് എൻ എക്സ്പോഷർ ഇൻ ലോ ലെവൽസ്, ലോ ലെവൽ എക്സ്പോഷർ വിൽ ലീഡ് ടു ഡിസീനസ് ആൻഡ് ഫാറ്റിക്. What is meant by dizziness and fatigue? That is cheenom talarche angane kendavum. If it is high exposure, high level exposure, chronic exposure will lead to kidney trouble and liver damage. High level exposure adu kidney trouble adalle liver damage undakum. Adu pole thanne low level anengil that will cause dizziness and fatigue. And this chloroform is commonly stored in colored bottles. Why? Because the chloroform, when react with this chloroform CHCl3, when react with oxygen in presence of sunlight, it produces a poisonous poisonous substance that is CuCl2, that is called phosgene. What is the name of this compound? This is phosgene with the liberation of HCl. So if you are balancing the equation will be like this: C2CHCl3 plus O. Here it is O2, oxygen. You'll get 2CoCl2 plus 2HCl. So why this is kept in colored bottles? That is to prevent the entering of the sunlight into the bottle. Oxygen presence in chloroform, sunlight to it chernet, oxygen to it cherna. ഫോസ്ജീൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന പോയിസണസ് സബ്സ്റ്റൻസ് ആണ് പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന. ഫോർമുല ഓർത്തിരിക്കണം, വാട്ട് ഇസ് എ ഫോർമുല ഫോസ്ജീൻ? ദറ്റ് ഇസ് CuCl2. റിമെമ്പർ ദാറ്റ്, വിത്ത് ദ പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് HCl. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് വൈ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് കെപ്റ്റ് ഇൻ കളേർഡ് ബോട്ടിൽസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എൻഡ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ലെസൺ. ഇന്നത്തെ ക്ലാസ് ഇവിടെ അവസാനിക്കുകയാണ്. വി ക്യാൻ സീ അഗെയിൻ. ഓക്കെ, ബൈ.